नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज कंपैरिजन ऑफ बिजनेस एम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड प्रोफेशन. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द क्लास. इन द लास्ट वर्चुअल सेशन ऑफ बिजनेस स्टडीज वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ बिजनेस. एक्टिविटीज विच आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू इकोनॉमिक एंड नॉन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज. इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज फर्दर क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स: बिजनेस, प्रोफेशन एंड employment. Business refers to those economic activities which are connected with production of goods, purchase and sale of goods or supply of services with the main object of earning profit. People engaged in business earn income in the form of profit. So we can say that business is sum total of all gainful human activities which aim to create, exchange and possess wealth in the form of physical output and useful services. The next part is profession. Profession includes those activities which require some special kind of knowledge and skills to be applied by the individuals in their occupation. Such activities are generally subject to guidelines or the code of conducts laid down by the professional bodies. The people who are engaged in professions are known as professionals. We can take the example of doctors who are engaged in the medical profession and are subject to the regulations of the Medical Council of India, the concerned professional body. Lawyers are engaged in the legal profession governed by the Bar Council of India, and chartered accountants belongs to the accounting profession and are subject to the regulations of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. The next part is employment. Employment refers to the occupation in which people work for others and get remunerated in return. Those who are employed by others are known as employees. People who work in the offices of bank, insurance companies or government department as managers, assistants, clerks, peons or security guards are the employees of these organizations. So this is the basic detail of these three. Now we start with the comparison of these three. In the comparison, we have some of the basics. According to the basics, we compare these three terms. First, I want to tell you one thing. The main objective of the business is to earn profit. In profession, the main objective is to provide services. And in employment, the main objective is to earn income in the form of salary or the wages by satisfying the needs of employer. So here we start with the basics. The first one is mode of establishment. Business may be established with the decision of an entrepreneur. That entrepreneur is a person who generally launch a new or the existing product in the market. Some of the legal formalities are also there according to the Companies Act. Those are also required to be followed up by the entrepreneur. Profession may be established on completion of a course and obtaining a degree from an institute. In employment, it is established by entering into a service agreement or the contract or by receiving the appointment letter from the employer. The second basic is nature of work. Business, the main nature of work of business is provision of goods and services to the public. In profession, rendering personalized and expert services, and in employment, performing the work or doing the duties as per the service contract. Third basic is qualification. In business, no minimum qualification is required to start any kind of business. In profession, qualification, expertise, and training in a specific field as prescribed by the professional body is mandatory. In employment, the qualification depends upon the nature of job or work. The next basic is reward. The reward of business is known as profit, and the professional feels the reward for profession, remuneration in the form of salary or wages is the reward for employment. The next basic is capital investment. Capital requirement depends on the scale of business, whether the organization is big or small, or which kind of services or goods the company is providing to their customers. In profession, limited capital investment is required, and in employment, no capital investment is needed. The next basic is risk. In business, there is always risk and uncertainty. In profession, there is a little risk. And in employment, there is no risk involved as the person is doing job for someone else. The next basic is transferability of ownership, means transfer of interest. Business can be easily transferred after following some necessary legal formalities from one person to another. But in profession and employment, it is not at all possible because that person personally possesses those qualifications. Last but not the least is code of conduct. In business, there is no prescribed code of conduct for business. But in profession, code of conduct is prescribed by the professional associates. In employment, the terms and conditions of service contract are applicable on employee. So these are the simple basics with the differences between business, profession and employment. You can go through with these points and the same kind of chart you are supposed to make in your copy.